Good morning students, today I am going to explain you about chapter 2, that is exponents. Now dear students, you have sufficient knowledge about exponents from your previous class. Now my question is, what is exponents? So from your previous class, if a number is denoted by like this, then in this number x is called base and n is called its power or exponent. Now by giving an example, if I write here 5 to the power 3, so here 5 is a base and 3 is a power or exponents. So what is the value of 5 to the power 3? Here to find out the power of 5 to the power 3, here we have to multiply 5 multiplied by 5, again 5 multiplied to 5, that is equal to 125. Now in your previous class, you have read about positive exponents. Now in this class 8, you have to learn about negative exponents. Okay, so again I have to take another one number, that is if a number x is denoted by its power minus n, then what is the value of x to the power minus n? So that to find out the value of x to the power minus n, we have to write 1 upon x to the power n. By taking one example, if I write here 5 to the power minus 3, so how do we get the value of 5 to the power minus 3? So here I have to write 1 by 5 power 3. That means 1 upon 125 by 1 upon 5 into 5 into 5. The value of 1 upon 125 equal to 5 into 5 into 5. Multiply karne se, we will get the value of 5 to the power 3. Now this one is called negative exponent. How do we get negative exponent? We get negative exponent by taking the reciprocal of 5. Reciprocal of 5 is 1 by 5. Why should we take 1 by 5 in case of a negative power? Now in this year, in your class 8, we have to learn more laws regarding exponents. In first law, when a by b is a number and its whole power is m. Why I use here whole? Whole means this both the number, that is numerator a and b, so whole power, common power is m, so that here I use word whole. Into a by b, whose also power is n. See here a by b both are base and this m and n are powers or exponent. So how do we get the value of this number? In case of multiplication, when powers are different, bases are same, then we should take base as a common and these two powers are to be added. Now next law is, whenever again these bases are same, but in case of multiply, here we should divide them. Then again this a by b is common, but in case of division these powers are to be subtracted. Now third one, when a by b has a whole power m and there is a whole power of a by b's power m, that is n. So how do we get the value of this number? A by b is common, but these two powers of powers get multiplied to each other, that is equal to a by b's power m n. Now fourth law, that is whenever a by b is multiplied by c by d and their common power is n. See students, here these two rational numbers are different, but their power is common, so that we can write here a by b's power is n into c by d's power is also n. Now in case if there is a division sign between these two rational numbers and power is common, that is fifth law, a by b divided by c by d whole power is n, in this case we should write a by b divided by c by d, and these numbers are to be separated by the same power, that is a by b's whole power is n divided by c by d's whole power is n. Okay, thank you. Next, laws of exponents. That is negative power. If a number is denoted by a negative power, then what is its value? So that previously I told you about whenever a number is denoted by negative power or exponents, there we should have to be change into them its reciprocal, that is a by b's reciprocal is b by a, and this power will get converted into positive. Next is zero power. Whenever a number is denoted by or its whole power is zero, then remember always its value is equal to 1. So these are the laws of exponents.